Most likely, and then perhaps we can ask our guest later, Congressman Tañada.
Well, let's bring him in. We have here also Tony and Bernadette, one of the spokespersons of the prosecution panel, Congressman Erin Tañada. Congressman, good evening.
Good evening, good evening. Adele, Linda, and Alex and Bernadette.
Yeah, a lot of, it's Tony, a lot of work covered today in the trial,
yes.
In stark contrast to yesterday. How are you feeling about this?
Well, if the witnesses arrived yesterday, this is the procedure that we would have wanted to happen. But, well, water under the bridge. So we said that since there was already an assurance that these witnesses would be appearing today, that we would just go through the same process.
Adele, you wanted to
Congressman
ask?
Aaron, are you going to use these SALENs prior to the SALENs when the Chief Justice was in the Supreme Court? Are you going to use this as a jump-off point to show any increase or decrease in the SALENs in relation to the charge under Article 2 of getting ill-gotten wealth?
Yes, without going to the merits of the case, we would be doing that. Because we'd like to like to show that there has been really no movement in the SALEN except maybe in the last year.
So contrary to, I guess, the general belief, you're going to say that there is you're going to show that there is no unusual or abnormal increase.
Yes.
Just 1 million, 2 million, in that range.
Yes.
In which case you want to prove that?
I want to prove that. Based on his statements of assets and liabilities and net worth, it would be hard for him to justify the acquisition of certain properties.
Including the one you mentioned in Article 2, yung dun sa Taguig City.
That's right, the Mega World properties. One thing that I noticed, Congressman Erin, is that you had witnesses who were not subject to the subpoena. And, you know, I guess the defense may claim that this is a bit of a surprise. Will you have other witnesses coming up who are also not subject of subpoena?
Well, we would not want to disclose that, but we're still even looking for possible corroborative witnesses that would help strengthen our positions on certain issues, especially with regard to the properties.
Okay, so tomorrow you are, aside from the records officer of the Office of the Vice President, you're also presenting the Register of Deeds.
And Register of Deeds, city assessors also of the respective cities.
Of six cities in Metro Manila, where the prosecution alleges that the Chief Justice has property.
Yes.
Okay, thank you very much, Congressman.
Thank you very much, Adele and Linda.
And we'll see you tomorrow.
Yes, another long day.
Tony, we're in there.
All right, well, it was also interesting, and now we're seeing as well that Congressman Yael Tupas is holding a press briefing as we speak, but earlier he also...